I've got a green light, Assassin. What do you see on Twitch? What? No, your mic is now not plugged in. This is great.
Blackness.
Yeah, it still says.
What's the deal with cussing? Are you guys like PG or?
Yeah, we're fucking PG. You can deal with it.
Okay, cool. All right, good deal.
Assassin, you see it or?
Si, señorita.
Right, let me mute the Skype call. Run the intro video and we'll get going.
Welcome to the Four Guys with Quarters show, with your hosts Inferno, Assassin, and Clowns.
All right, and welcome to a late edition of the Four Guys with Quarters podcast, episode 76 for February 18th, 2016. I'm Inferno217. We have with us, making his 76th straight appearance, ZPCI Assassin.
Hi.
We have Maverick2474 filling in, a.k.a. Cody, this week for Turtle.
What's up?
We've got Italian Clowns, as always. What's up, Clowns?
Hey, what's going on? And I don't see us on YouTube yet.
No, I don't know why. You see us on Twitch, Assassin?
Yeah, I see us on Twitch.
Yep.
I mean, it's streaming to Restream.
Okay.
So, hopefully it's just a glitch. Anyway, I guess this week we've got Southbound.
What's up, man?
TXR podcast, and also Phil Spencer's vacation buddy. Am I right about that?
Unofficially. I'm just his caddy. You know what I mean? I do random, things around the house.
Nice.
Jack of all trades. You know what I mean?
Awesome. Yeah, South, we're excited to have you, man. Thanks for coming.
Thank you for having me. I really appreciate it, guys.
Yeah, absolutely. So this week we're going to talk about some Quantum Break stuff. It's going to be a lot of stuff that we had last week, but we're going to get some of Southbound's opinions on it, a little bit of Cody's opinion on it, and see where the gaming community stands still on Quantum Break, the PC release saga, if you will, that we discussed last week. We'll also talk about a little bit of Rocket League now that it's out on Xbox One. We'll talk about our impressions of it, what we're thinking, if it's cool or not, if it's different from the PS4. I mean, it's obviously cool, but we'll get opinions. We'll talk about Street Fighter V and how much of a flop that was. And we'll talk about a little bit of Fallout 4 DLC. The price is changing, people. Get your money in now if you're going to get it. That kind of deal. More details to follow. So, yeah, so why don't we just let Southbound give a little bit of an intro before we get started. Obviously, you're a member of the TXR podcast, but tell us a little bit about what else you do in the community and how you guys even started the TXR podcast.
Well, you know what? Obviously, like you know, there's many, many podcasts out there. And, a lot of people, like the guys from BGST, Zaire, Mooch, and, Tim Dog, they're like, hey, South, you need to do a podcast. You know what I mean? And I'm like, who really wants to hear what I have to say? I'm not really a man of a lot of words. You know what I mean? So I sat down and, over a few months, I kind of, was mulling it over. And I kind of wanted to do something different. I didn't want to do just a normal, hey, we got a group of guys and we're just talking about the same shit that everybody else talks about, because for me, certain subjects just get real stale. And if you got, seven different podcasts talking about the same subject, it gets old. Mm-hmm. So we decided to kind of, how it started, we said, we're going to start, it'll be us guys talking, our group, but then we'll kind of start to like feature different guys in the community. And, kind of give a podium for people that don't normally have one to, speak their mind. And, because everybody knows each other on Twitter.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? But you really don't, you know, you want to put a face to the typing and, you know, the 140 characters. You want to know, you want to get to know with people that you're, you know, interacting with.
Yep.
So, and then it just kind of, you know, we started getting a few interviews and, you know, we gotten some pretty good, you know, decent guys and some big names, and it's just kind of snowballing from there. So, you know, now here we are. I'm not saying we're like the biggest podcast ever, because obviously we're not. Yeah. But, you know, we got a good thing going, and we got a good group of guys, and, you know, it's going good, so.
It's a very good thing. I really, like, the TXR podcast, I think, is very, very good. I listen pretty much every week I can.
Well, I appreciate that. We appreciate everybody's, you know, support and input, and, you know, we don't mind being critiqued, and, you know, I mean, obviously everybody gets hate.
Oh, yeah,
you know?
Absolutely.
You know, it's like, you know, we had Ryan McCaffrey on the other day, and someone in the comments section were like, why is he doing such a little ghetto podcast? You know, and it's like,
wow.
I'm Southbound, bitch. Don't you know? No. No, you know, it's just, you know, Ryan's a really cool guy, and he just, you know, he took a shot on us, and, you know, we appreciate that.
Yeah. I mean, we're not, I know you guys aren't the same, you know, this way either, but we're definitely not a podcast that, like, says, you know, don't watch other people's podcasts, you know, because different opinions are good. You know, getting a bunch of opinions is really good. And like you said, like, watching the same old every single podcast is definitely, you know, boring. But I think, you know, we all cover, like, a lot of different stuff. Like, I don't feel like our format is like TXR at all, and TXR isn't really like BGST. And
right. You know, so basically we just wanted to do something a little bit different.
Yeah, it's good. It's good. So I suggest everybody, you know, check out TXR as well.
Thank you.
Yeah, definitely. We included the YouTube rather, below South's picture there. So definitely just check out TXR Space Podcast on YouTube. You guys got questions for South? I know. Sasson does.
I forgot him.
Dude, about Phil, about Phil Spencer?
Oh, my man Phil.
Didn't you?
No.
Thought it was you. Maybe it was Turtle. Anyway, somebody brought up what, like, the first interaction with Phil was. Somebody wanted to ask what the first interaction with Phil Spencer was. How you guys first, like, got together?
My first interaction with Phil was E3 right after he got the big boss job.
Oh, okay.
And, you know, everybody was kind of, you know, they did their little their E3 press conference, and it was, you know, it was after the briefing, and I went up to him, and I kind of, you know, shook his hand, and I said, wow, you know, I go, you're the people's champ, you know, you're the man of the people. That, like, everybody was so buzzing still from him getting a job, because he was only on the job maybe like a month or two.
Right.
And so everybody's like, yeah, we got actually a gamer in charge and not some suit and a business guy. I mean, obviously he's a businessman, but he's one of us. He's a gamer.
That's right, baby.
You know, it's not all about the money, the bottom line. You know, he cares about, you know, if you ever talk to him, he'll tell you, oh, God, I can't stand, you know, screen tearing, or, you know, like, he's a
critique. Oh, really?
Yeah, oh, yeah. He's on it. And he's a very honest person, you know.
That's awesome, yeah. We've said it many times on the show. That's the kind of guy we need at the top of this company. We need somebody, you know, to push the gamer's perspective into the light of the, you know, suits and stuff. We need Xbox to be, you know, we need people at the top to make Xbox, like, relevant, I guess. I don't want to see, like, Microsoft spin it off or anything. Like, you hear rumors of that shit, and, like, Microsoft wants to get rid of Xbox.
I mean, obviously, I haven't heard nothing, you know, officially, you know. I hear rumors just like everybody else, but
right.
As far as what I heard, that is not going to happen.
Yeah.
You know, if they're not going to be sold to Amazon, so, you know, you don't got to worry about that. You know, you're not going to be able to buy books from your Xbox One. So, sorry, but that's not happening.
Oh. No, I definitely don't want that. I definitely don't want Amazon to own it. No, but I think Microsoft's doing a good job. I think they're realizing, you know, even though they're not, like, you know, the number one globally, you know, if you depend on NPD numbers, I think they realize that they have an asset here. And I think they're not just going to let it go.
They're making money. Right. You know, yeah, obviously they're not selling like the PS4 is, but it's very, very profitable. Xbox Live is bringing a lot of money, you know. If you ever listen to, you know, Phil or somebody talk, now they have a seat at the table with Windows and Office, you know, and the Azure. They're sitting at the big table. They're eating with the big dogs now. It ain't like when the original Xbox came out and they had a little corner on the far end of the campus.
You know? Right.
Now they're, you know, they're at have a seat at the table.
Right, right.
They're integral. You know, I got a chance to talk to Satya after E3 last year. And that was one of the things I told him. I said, please don't ever sell Xbox. And he looked at me, you know, kind of, you know, rolled his eyes in the back of his head. He said, oh, no. Xbox is important to us.
Yeah.
That made me feel good. Obviously, I'm nobody, you know what I mean? But to hear him say it, you know, that's the big boss.
Yeah, so, yeah.
You know, I don't think that he's bullshitting me, but.
Right, right.
You know.
Yeah, I'm glad not to see it going anywhere. Glad that we can have a podcast and actually talk about it and not talk about, you know, a fire sale or anything where Xbox is going away. Xbox is living strong, doing well. It's good. It's good to hear that. So,
yeah,
What else? Oh, so Quantum Break. I know you guys talked about Quantum Break on TXR a little bit. Talked about it on BAGST a little bit. Or maybe it was Crossfire. I don't remember. But you guys talked very much about. No, it was definitely. Actually, it was definitely BGST. Where you guys talked about the Xbox versus PC controversy.
Well, so, yeah. I mean, you know, obviously you knew Twitter exploded after that. You know, everybody felt blindsided, whether you hated it, loved it, or anywhere in between. Everybody was very vocal on social media.
Mm-hmm. Other guys in the on the panel, and it's now a week, it's almost a week later. Has the dust settled? Is it different than what we talked about last week, or is it the same? Is it still a controversy? Is it not even a big deal in the first place? What do the other guys think?
I think there's still some babies crying about it, the coming of Windows 10, but they're dying down. I hope. I don't search the internet. But
I don't mean to cut you off, my friend, but yep. I don't see it going away anytime soon.
Really?
It's, a lot of people are pissed, and, you know, they feel, you know, whether it's rightfully or not, they feel like they were lied to. You know, they don't understand. Now, as Xbox One owner, they feel like there's nothing special and a reason to own an Xbox anymore because you can get your games on PC. Mm-hmm. Me, personally, I'll never own a PC. I'll never be a PC gamer. Right. But I love my Xbox. And as long as I'm able to get all the games on my Xbox, I really could give two shits about it.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
You know, exactly. It doesn't impact me as a gamer.
Exactly. I feel the same way with you on that, South. Like, I mean, for me, I don't really think it's a big deal. I understand the fact, though, like, on Twitter and Reddit, everybody said, you know, it said Xbox One exclusive. So, yeah, I can understand their pain. They feel like a little slighted. Like, you know, this was supposed to be an Xbox One exclusive, not a Xbox cross-brand exclusive. So I can understand the upset behind it. In the end, though, I think that the decisions that were made were probably pressure on Phil and the team because they need the numbers up, and I think that's what the user install base is. You know, is the game going to really work out on the PC the way it's expected? I don't know. I mean, there's issues with the Windows 10 store, and Windows 10 is still kind of like a new baby, and, you know, there's, what you call it, they're still beta testing some of the Windows 10 features and stuff, so a lot's to be seen on the potential Windows 10 in the store.
Mm-hmm. Definitely. Cody, I know you felt pretty strongly about this. Now you have your platform on our show, so please do say it and say it proud, say it loud about how you feel about this issue.
This is what's wrong with the country. Everybody's just a bunch of whiny-ass babies. Get the heck over it. Okay, so your complaint is that more gamers get to play a great game. Seriously, get over it. That's completely stupid. Just who cares? So more gamers get to play a great game. This means that, you know, the developers get to make more money to make more great games. So what? Get over it.
That's right. Jay Street.
Well, like I said.
Oh, sorry, guys.
Sorry, man. But that's the problem. It's not so much that, oh, more people get to play it. Their argument is now, as an Xbox owner who's got it from day one, who's spent time, money, you know, time on podcasts and, you know, yelling back and forth, now what are they fighting for anymore? What makes you special as an Xbox console owner?
What makes me special is the fact that I can sit on my couch with my wife, play with my Xbox, talk to my Xbox, do everything I want to with my wife sitting there, play my games I want to. I don't have to have this big old machine in front of me. I don't have to have this. I got a $3,000 gaming laptop. Do I touch it? I use it for Microsoft Word. That's it. I don't like gaming on a PC, and there's thousands of millions of people out there who don't like gaming on PCs. So you know what? Let the PC gamers have their game. Let us have our game. I'm never going to be a PC gamer. I've bought thousands of dollars worth of games on this thing, and I don't touch them. I can't stand this mouse, controller, PC. No, I hate it. And there's a lot of people out there just like me. So let them have their game that we're going to have. So what? I get to play it on my Xbox. So do you. So does everyone else. So if they want to play it on a PC, more power to them. I'm going to play it on my Xbox, and I'm always going to play on my Xbox. I'm never going to be a PC gamer.
But here's the flip side of that, too. Like, I read all the PC gamers' comments, and like, oh, it's not coming on Steam? Well, I'm not touching it. So, like, I mean, there might be, like, 1% of out of that 200 million on Windows 10 that might actually play it through the Windows 10 store. So I can see that complaint. I mean, hopefully Microsoft will buy Steam one day. That's the only solution.
Oh, yeah.
That'll never happen.
I mean, did you just wake up right now?
Yeah. This just became a fairy tale podcast, didn't it?
Oh, my God. Listen to this dreamer, huh, South? He wants Microsoft to buy Steam.
Yeah, you know, I got a bridge right here that, you know, I could probably sell to you for a good price.
Oh, man.
Does it have the Xbox logo on there?
No, but it is Xbox green.
Is it?
Oh, okay.
I'll have to think about it.
Yeah, look it up, Vincent Thomas Bridge.
J Street, not Chat, says, the crybabies need to get a life. People just want to brag and say you can only play it on the Xbox and that's it. And I think I agree with you, J Street. I think there is a part of it that's what it is. I think people just want something to be just theirs and no one else can have it. You know, it's that mindset. It's, to me, it's crazy, but there are people out there that are saying that, you know?
Well, people want to feel special. People want, you know, if you go out and buy a vehicle that has a feature that no other car has, you're going to brag about it.
Yep.
You know, so, I mean, I get it. I want to make a big deal about it and scream from the rooftops? No, Microsoft lied to me, a big company. They just totally, you know, I don't know, you know, I don't get it, but I understand, you know, certain people's argument.
My thought is, if you're going to be upset about it, that's fine. Like, be a little upset about it. But, like, if you already have it pre-ordered and it causes you to cancel your pre-order and just not support the company anymore, I think that's a little far, don't you?
If you want to feel special, go talk to your mommy. Otherwise, just play a damn video game.
Oh, wow. The hard takes here.
Damn.
America.
You guys broke my heart. I'm hurting.
No, but I mean, some people are saying that. Like, some people are saying, oh, you know, I'm so hurt by this move, I'm not going to buy the game anymore. So you don't like the game all of a sudden? You don't like the game all of a sudden?
I think, there's two sides to the story. The flip side is the being misled part. I mean, think about this. If Sony PlayStation VR and all the Sony people that are happy about this went out and, like, pre-ordered it and all that crap, right? And all of a sudden they're like, oh, yeah, well, we're going to make it multi-platform. I mean, like, they would be slighted, too. So, I mean, there's a flip side to this. It's the misleading part.
This is part of that poor me attitude everybody's got. Get over it.
But you know what? It's not so much the poor me attitude. It's Microsoft's wording in their message. You know, they honestly, people would have been fine with it if it wasn't a month until the release date.
Agreed. Yeah, that's the thing.
That's the major point.
Yeah.
Because it's only a few weeks before the game actually comes out, and all of a sudden you feel blindsided. Boom! Oh shit! So it's not the exclusive.
But why is it a blindsided thing? It's not like they came out and said, "Sorry, Xbox One, we're going to just PC." You still get your damn game. Who cares if they put it somewhere else? It's not a blindside.
But I mean,
in a month.
It's been on development though for a while to port it to the PC. So like people feel that it should have been mentioned previously before they tagged the Xbox One exclusive on it.
And the box art, too. The box art, man, was out that said, you know, Xbox One. We had it last week on the show, you know, that said Xbox One exclusive. You know, I mean, it's little things, but, I mean, you know, people get pissed about little things in this world.
They really do. People buy a PS4, they buy an Xbox One for exclusive games to their console.
Yeah.
And like I said, to me, I really could give two shits whether a game. I mean, obviously, I'll probably get a lot of hate for it, but I don't care if Halo went to PS4. You know what I mean? As long as I get to play it on my Xbox, I really don't give a damn.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. I don't own a PlayStation. I never will. I can't stand it. That has nothing to do with the games. I'd love to play Persona, but I'm not going to buy a PlayStation because I don't like the console. I don't like the controller. I don't like the way they get hacked all the time. I don't like the way they took $800 out of my account when they got hacked. I'm just never going to touch the damn console.
Well, and that's your right as a consumer. And
exactly.
And it's also people's rights to complain when they feel like the company that they're supporting is not being on the up and up.
Yeah, it's... I think people being upset about the honesty and the clarity thing, I think they may have a point. Even though I'm still going to support this and still buy Quantum Break, I don't know if I can really, really argue. Like, if I were sitting, you know, and talking one-on-one to somebody and they said, you know, they weren't really clear with this, you know, like J Street says in the chat, maybe they kept delaying it because they definitely wanted to get it to PC and they didn't want to tell people. Like, I mean, that's kind of a little conspiracy theory-ish, but I mean, could that possibly be true?
Well, here's my deal. Who says this is the developer's fault? Who said Xbox said, you're going to release this, you're going to make it for Windows 10 too, no questions asked? Why should the developer lose your money because they get told what to do? You have no idea who
Well, you know what? Xbox owns the IP. So when it came down to it, it was Microsoft's decision.
Right, right.
You know, I think that in their minds, they obviously knew that there was going to be some kind of backlash and people were going to have a problem with it. But I think that their way of counteracting that was saying, well, listen, you're buying it for Xbox, and you're going to get it for free for Windows 10. So I thought that they thought that, well, you know what, we're kind of, you know, making up for the people that feel slighted. And it agreed. Really didn't go over like they thought it would.
Yep, I agree. I think the fact that this has turned into a controversy has totally overshadowed the fact that you're getting three games for free, you know? Three full, like, excellent games. Alan Wake, man.
Never played it
before.
But see, that's the thing. Me personally, I'm not much of a backwards compatible guy, so I really don't care about 360 games. I bought an Xbox One so I can play the 2016 games,
right.
Not the 2006 games.
That's
you know?
True. Yeah.
I've never been one of them sentimental guys where, you know, I can't wait to go back to Super Mario. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I'd play it for like 2 minutes, and I'm like, I'm done with that. I wouldn't even play it on my phone. You know what I mean?
Yep. Graphic God in the chat says, my attitude is that the PC is now another Xbox item, much like the Vita is to PlayStation. I own a powerful rig, but I never play games on it. And you know what? Graphic God, last week on the show, we were kind of like thinking that maybe that's the spin on this. Like, Xbox is now going to become like a brand that includes Windows 10 gaming. Like, Windows 10 gaming... You have the Xbox app on Windows 10. You have the achievements on Windows 10. You have the Xbox Live experience on Windows 10. So, like, Windows 10 PC and, quote-unquote, Windows 10 dashboard or whatever on Xbox One is all going to be one ecosystem, so it's still an Xbox item.
And you know see, that's what? The thing. Oh, go ahead. I'm sorry.
Oh, that's all right. I was going to say, if you go back into the show's archives about a year and a half ago, I said it first on this show, and I even tweeted Phil Spencer.
Oh, here we
back
go.
Then, I said that to build up your install base so that Xbox can maintain profitability, you should go ahead and brand an Xbox store on the PC. I said that like a year and a half ago. I predicted it was coming. I told Inferno, I've told Assassin. You know, I don't know. I don't like the way they did it, but I predicted it.
Well, can I get this week's lottery numbers while you're at it then?
Same. I'll split the Powerball with you, Cody.
Done.
You know what? We can bag on clowns, but I do vaguely remember that. I can't even lie. I do vaguely remember that.
Friendship over.
What were you going to say, South, about that? About the Xbox ecosystem?
Anybody that paid attention knew that it was eventually going to happen. It was inevitable. Yeah. And going with, you know, how Satya at the top wants, you know, Microsoft, everything, it's a service. You know, you got all, you know, you got Cortana on iPhone now and Android. You know, you got Word on Android and iPhone. So mm-hmm. You knew this was coming.
Yeah.
You know, and people, I mean, it's like, I know this is a bad analogy, but it's kind of like waiting for a sick friend or relative to, you know, that's real sick. You know they're going to die. But when they die, you're like, oh, my God, I wasn't prepared.
Right.
Damn.
I know that's a bit drastic.
That's a little sad and morbid, but I mean, it's kind of true.
It's kind of like the idea. You know what I mean? I don't know exactly how to, you know, better to put it, but.
No, I hear you.
You can never be prepared, even though you know in the back of your mind it's coming. Like Clown said, a year ago I knew, you know, because ever since, what was it, GDC last year, you knew that the ecosystem was coming together and they wanted to kind of, you know, marry them, you know. While there is, it's all Microsoft's offerings.
Right.
You know, yep. So, go ahead.
And, you know, going forward for Microsoft, I predicted this the same time last year, and I'm going to predict it again so everybody can hear it, but I predict that going forward, I don't know if it's going to be the next-gen Xbox or the one after that, but it's going to be more built like a Steam machine where it's upgradable. Like slots, slot in CPU, slot in RAM, everything upgradable.
I think
upgradable.
That's what a lot of people think. You know, a lot of people want to have the iPhone option, whether you can upgrade every year or 2 years.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But I think the next Xbox, and a lot of people, oh, there's not going to be a next Xbox. Bullshit. It's already in the
be. Right.
They're, you know, even though they're not, you know, selling like the PS4, they're still making money. So they would be stupid to not make another Xbox.
Right.
Yep.
Right.
Yep. The only one that needs to hang up their towel now is Nintendo.
I don't know. They're always going to have their exclusive games and their catalog to rely on, to fall back on.
The NX will be
awesome.
What
they need to do, they need to get in with the third-party developers and make nice with them, because that's the only way that Nintendo is going to thrive going into the future.
Right.
Every other Nintendo console has been amazing. Every other one. So last one sucked. This one will be awesome.
Interesting. So the GameCube sucked?
Dude, GameCube sucked.
Really?
Wow. Yes.
No.
Trash. Last
wow,
great
really?
Nintendo system was Super NES, at least for me.
No, so then GameCube sucked and N64 was good. So you're saying SNES sucked?
No.
Okay, there's more to Nintendo than just that. They've got their handhelds, they've got that.
Oh, okay.
Every console they release, there's a good one and a bad one. If you stream them all out, good, bad, good, bad, good, bad, based on how they come out, every other one is awesome, every other one sucks. So the NX is going to be incredible.
Okay,
like,
all right.
Like Virtual Boy?
Yeah, come on. What is that?
Wow. Assassin, any last word on this? You think this is going to stick around, this controversy, or you think it's just going to go into the sunset?
It's going to stick around. Let's be honest.
Yeah. Sadly.
We just need a PC streaming tax max one. And then there we go.
Interestingly, Graphic God in the chat says he has a prediction. He thinks that before they discontinue the 360, they're going to have an Xbox One app to stream Xbox One to 360. That would be interesting. I don't know if that's even possible.
Why?
But that'd be,
why?
I mean, like, are you talking about like the, because that it would be like the PSTV or whatever that came out of PlayStation that kind of failed. So I don't know. Maybe they see the writing on the wall there.
I think when it comes to the 360, they're done supporting it. They want to move on, because a lot of people think they're giving up on the Xbox One. So why would they still support the 360 when the current generation now, they're, you know, if you listen to a lot of people, they think that they're done with that. So why would they take two steps back?
Yeah. Yep. And I think like the PST, like the equivalent would be like the PlayStation TV that it, like, did not do well at all. It, like, that was like a fire sale. I mean, do they even still sell that?
Clowns? Like $39, and the only people that want to buy it are hackers for the TNV firmware.
Right. Anyway, so kind of a thing that kind of came out recently about Quantum Break on the PC that may kind of like dispel all this nonsense, or a good amount of it, is that in order to play on like high to ultra settings, you have to have a beast of a machine. Do you guys see the recommended specs for this thing?
Well, I heard that they updated it and they lowered it a little bit.
Oh, did they lower it? I grabbed these today. I still think these are pretty nuts. You need Windows 10, like 100%. So anyone who's on Windows 7, you're not going to play this. So you're going to have to update to Windows 10. I mean, not like it's cost a lot of money, since it was technically free. I don't know if it still is. But yeah, these specs that I grabbed today say you need like an i7 4790, like a graphics card that's like $400 minimum for recommended specs. So like, you're still gonna be, you can go out and buy an Xbox One for $300 or less. You know, you can find one out there for $300. So I mean, if anything, you're saving a lot of money by playing it on the Xbox One versus getting a PC that, or it, you know, updating your PC with a graphics card that's like $400-$500.
Yeah, to me that just does not appeal to me. I don't like when it comes to PC gaming. That's what turns me off the most, is because it seems like every year you got to update something. You got to spend another $600 for the next greatest, latest graphics card, or yep, you know, water cooler, whatever might have. Nice. To me, it just seems like it's ridiculous. You know,
it is. Yeah, it is.
But you know, looking at those specs, it makes sense why Microsoft did this, and I see it now, is because they want to force people to upgrade to like more modern CPUs, because Windows 10 is going to stop supporting older CPUs.
Right. Right.
I see what they did.
So, yeah. So, I mean, if you just look at these games, like every sequential game that comes out, and South has a good point there, like having to always update the systems and get the newest, greatest thing. Like every sequential game that comes out, it's like recommended specs. And it's like a processor that just came out recently. And then the GPU that, you know, is not even a year old. And then this and that. And you're always like, oh, well, guess I'm going to have go to the Best Buy or go to Amazon or Newegg and buy myself a new graphics card, and this one's just going to go in the trash or whatever. So,
yeah, because I have friends, obviously, that have, you know, crazy gaming rigs. And, you know, I know a buddy that spent, it was like $10,000 on some crazy
rig. Holy shit.
Yeah, it was like crazy ridiculous, you know. And here we are like 2 years later. And it's not even half as good as it once was.
Right, right. Depreciates, you know? Yeah, it's just the depreciation on all those things. It's ridiculous.
To me, that just sounds like a money pit, and I have no desire to ever get into that.
The problem is, I mean, they're so far ahead in technology on what they want to like develop that every 3 months something new's coming out for the PC.
That's right, right. Yeah. Graphic God in the chat says, he priced out the minimum specs in the CPU and the GPU total over $500 for the min specs on Quantum Break. So there you go. I mean, like, look at the 360. Like, 10 years down the road, there were still good games that, I mean, they didn't look like ultra graphics on PC, but you still bought your 360 and you had it for 10 years. You paid $300-$400 for it. You know, like, that's another advantage to console gaming that people don't even consider. Like, yeah, obviously the graphics are better on PC if you run it ultra, but like for these specs that we have listed here on the show, like you're paying $1,000. You're paying $1,000. So
yeah, that doesn't sound fun to me. I'm sorry.
Yeah, it's ridiculous. And then you have to use a keyboard and mouse, dude. I haven't gamed with a keyboard and mouse in forever. I guess you can plug in a controller. You can plug in the Xbox.
I can barely walk and chew gum at the same time. I couldn't do the keyboard and mouse thing.
Nice.
You know, it, like I'd totally have to learn a whole different way of gaming. And then, oh, but you can use your 360 controller, your Xbox One controller. And I'm still, I don't. It sounds like too much workarounds, and you have to do this to get, you know, 60 frames. Blah 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 blah. It just seems way too much to deal with. I'd rather just, you know, tell my Xbox what game I want to play, grab my controller, and boom, Xbox Live brings it to me.
That's right. So, here you go. Here's the outrage on the PC. Assassin, do you have to, or Assassin or Cody, you guys have anything to say about this? These specs?
That's just stupid.
I mean, it is. It is. It's ridiculous. You have these specs that you have to pay ridiculous money for. Like, just get it on the Xbox. Like, come on.
If you have an Xbox. I wonder if my computer can run it.
Dude, your computer cannot run it, bro.
Your computer can't run Pong, dude.
Again.
Dude, I remember one time you tried to stream, like, Star Wars Battlefront off the PS2, and it was like a shit show. Right?
Yeah.
Yeah, or like your PC or something, and it was just a shit show.
Yeah, weren't you like, oh, what's this smell? And I was like, oh, it's probably going on fire. And you're like, oh.
It ran Tomb Raider pretty good. not the 50s.
No, it didn't.
Yeah, the one from like the 1970s.
No,
yeah,
the not the newest one. But
you mean like the Game Boy Color one?
Probably. Probably.
The reboot.
Anyway, yeah, so that's the Quantum Break stuff. I mean, I know we went over it last week, but we got some good opinions here. Glad we went over it again. Let us know, people, if you're outraged. Hit us on Twitter or Facebook or in the chat now if you're watching, or YouTube comments.
Or if you want Assassin to do a rain dance over it, he will.
Yeah, I'll pay to see that. You take PayPal?
Assassin, you definitely take PayPal.
Yeah, sure.
Like direct deposit, I take it all. Cashier's check, Western Union.
Taco Bell gift cards, perhaps.
Oh, shit, who doesn't want a 7-layer burrito, bro?
Oh, my God. All right, so other news this week. I don't know if you guys have heard, but, you know, Rocket League came to Xbox One.
You mean soccer cars?
Soccer cars, as our buddy Mooch likes to call it. Funny how Mooch is, like, the biggest fan of the game now that it's on Xbox, huh?
Well, you know what? He bashed the hell out of the game. Don't there's no ifs and buts about it. He ripped it a new one for months.
Yep.
And it wasn't so much the game itself. It was just because it was an indie game and everybody was just touting it so much. And that was the PS4 system seller.
It really was. It really was.
It's like they had Bloodborne and Rocket League last year.
Yep.
That was the main attractions for the PlayStation. And so, go ahead, sorry.
And they made it free with PS Plus.
Yeah, so should Xbox One owners be pissed off, South, you think, about Xbox One not getting it?
It's actually kind of funny because I did mention to Phil, you know, because everyone was talking about it. Like, yeah, we're going to play. And I said, you know, honestly, unless I get a review code or something, I'm not buying it. And it's, listen, the price doesn't bother me. The $20, I mean, I spend $20 on lunch. You know what I mean?
So yeah,
it's not the point. The point is, like you said, PlayStation got it for free for a month.
Yep.
We should have had it free for a month.
Absolutely.
You know, it's just turnabout's fair play. So as an Xbox fan, I felt a little slighted, but the game, that doesn't say the game is bad, or the game's actually really, really fun, because I did, in fact, get a code, and I'm enjoying it. The game is really, really fun, so I understand all the hype that it got.
Right, but for like a $20 little, I understand, like an indie title to be a system seller, and everybody's like, oh, this is the next coming of Christ.
Right, yeah, people are falling over themselves over it. Yeah. And it, like I said, nothing bad about the game, but you're selling PS4s off of an indie game. That was pretty amazing, you know. And that's why Mooch had his stance on it so strongly.
Yeah.
But last night we were playing the hell out of it, and we were having a good damn time.
Oh yeah, the game is awesome itself.
It's great. It's great. J Street in the chat says game's fun, indie or not. It's not. J Street. It's less about. It's not like we're bashing because it's an indie. It's just like amazement. That, like, so many people were like, oh, this is the thing that makes the PlayStation 4, and it's just like an indie game with cars that run around and hit a ball. You know what I mean? Like,
right.
That's what it is.
It's mindless fun, you know? And like I said, I get that everybody was enjoying it and, you know, really loving it, but for me, and listen, I own a PS4, so it's not like I'm just a total Sony basher, because I respect what they do.
Same.
And, you know, I'm an Xbox guy. That's my preference. That's where all my friends are. And that's where I, you know, that's where I eat my dinner. That's where I lay my head at night. You know
that's
what I mean?
Right. That's right,
home.
Baby. Yep. Yep. So yeah, it's $20. We didn't get the month free. Some people are upset about it, obviously. Some people aren't and still bought it. And I don't know the sales numbers, so I don't even ask.
But I heard unofficially, 11 million or some shit. I don't know if that's true.
Yeah, total, though, not on Xbox.
Really, are you talking across the board?
Well, I don't know if it was across the board or whatever, but they got some pretty big numbers. If you look at your friends list the last couple of days.
Everybody's been playing it, man.
Well, actually, you know what? I'll look it up right now, my friends, because you could see how many people have played it.
Bro, the night it came out, bro, I looked on my friends list and went to the game hub, and there were 10 people. out of the 32 that I had online that were playing it.
And South, there's that one really awesome dude on Xbox that plays it. His name is Italian Clowns. I don't know him.
I've never heard of him.
I don't know if you've seen his goal shots, but it's like epic.
Yeah, but they're self goals, so that doesn't count.
Oh, yeah. Shit.
Yeah, any retard can put the spoon to his mouth. You know what I mean?
Oh, wow. This guy's full of analogies tonight.
Hey, I'm channeling my inner Mooch.
Nice. You know what I mean? Yep.
Mooch is the king of analogies.
He really is, man.
I love that dude. He would be a good redneck.
He's not even close to a redneck.
No, he's like Italian American like me. But you know what they call Italians down south, right? Because I get called this for no reason. Roughneck. Roughneck.
Oh, you wish they called you a roughneck.
Nope, they do down south. They call all Italians.
I've been down south.
I live in the south. I've never heard that in my life.
I can't say I've ever heard that either, Clowns.
I've lived part time most of my life below the Mason Dixon, and I've never heard that.
You ever go to the Podunk parts of Florida, like around the Everglades and all that?
Florida's about as Yankee as you can get in the south.
No, right? Nope. It's not as Yankee as you get in the south.
Yeah, it kind of is.
If you're talking about Tallahassee, that's pretty redneck, but. Yeah, I wouldn't consider Florida the South.
No.
Right.
I think, once you get past Georgia, that's the line.
Nice.
Isn't that a band, Florida Georgia Line?
Florida Georgia Line, baby.
Yeah, yep. That's right. Telling you right there, that's where the South ends, buddy.
Yep. Nice.
Then starts the Cuban line.
The exactly. Cuban line. Well, I'm originally from Pennsylvania anyway, so it doesn't bother me, but... Yep.
Oh, did we just lose him? Clowns, you there?
Yeah, I'm here.
Oh, okay. thought we lost you for a second there.
It's hard from Cuba, I'll tell you.
Right, exactly. Exactly. The reception's not good down there.
He said roughneck.
Dude, I'm telling you, man. You come out to parts of Florida, that's what they call it.
Okay, I'll let you tell it.
Whatever makes you sleep at night.
Right.
J Street in the chat says it's 11 million total downloads across all platforms, but even so, holy shit.
Yeah, that's a lot.
That's a lot.
Wait a minute, though.
We don't know how much is the free, you know what I mean? We don't know how many people on PlayStation, if that includes the free downloads.
Yes, yeah, I bet you it does. Yeah, that's a good point.
That kind of skews the number a little bit.
Definitely. I'd love to see the Xbox numbers. I certainly hope it's successful on Xbox, even with the $20 price tag, and even though we didn't get it for free. I hope there are people... that are so pissed they aren't going to get it, you know?
They're like, I refuse to pay $20 for this game.
Well, you have both, though, bro. You know what I mean? You have a PlayStation. Like, if you only had an Xbox.
Well, I never bought it on my
PlayStation. Oh, you never got it? Okay.
I'm a virgin, bro.
Virgin, yep.
It's popping my cherry.
Popping that soccer car cherry, baby.
What did Jeremy say to me on Twitter? He was going to take a soccer car.
I don't pay attention to anything that guy says.
Wow. Oh, man. Cody or Assassin, thoughts on Rocket League? What have you guys thought about it so far on Xbox? I know Assassin's played it on PS4, so we'll let Cody go first since he's the noob.
I like it. Me and Assassin and Clowns were playing a few matches earlier before the podcast. First time I've ever played it, and it's fun. I had a blast. Worth $20 easily.
Definitely. Definitely.
Oh, yeah. No, it is. Because, people were asking me, hey, you got an extra code? I'm like, really? It's $20. Go buy it. And I'm such a hypocrite because I wouldn't even buy it myself. But
yeah, I was surprised. My brother, who I game share with, doesn't really, play a lot of, a diverse amount of games. And we have a PlayStation 4 and... lived together at the time, and he was playing it on PlayStation 4, but as soon as it came to Xbox, it's kind of like that little exposure to PlayStation, now that he didn't have it, made him want to buy it, you know what I mean? Like, if they had, a trial, I think that would be so clutch. Like, if you could have, a 60-minute trial on Xbox, I think people would be like, oh, this is the real deal. Like, I'm hooked.
Well, you fail to realize the power of word of mouth. You see all your friends. Like, I just look right now on my friends list, how many people are playing the game. And I don't know how many people bought it or got codes, but 45 people
Holy shit!
So that's pretty good numbers.
Yeah, I mean, word of mouth and videos is doing it for them right now. 11 million. It's nuts. 11 million.
And it's funny because if you're like a BGST fan, it's like a guilty pleasure because you were led to hate this for the last 6 months, but now that you actually got it on your console, you're like, holy shit, it's actually pretty damn fun.
Dude, I would love to hear Mooch just admit that it's fun.
He said it many times. He actually, the first night, he played it because Jeremy bought him the game. Because Jeremy was like, man, Mooch, you talk about soccer cards and it's really fun. He's like, you know what? So when they announced that it's coming out on Xbox, he said, I'm buying it for you and we're playing. Nice. So first thing, as soon as it dropped, Jeremy was good on his word and he bought him a copy of it. And so if you go back to his tweets a couple days, he goes, I had a really good time, dare I say, soccer cars, And yep. And right now he's getting a lot of shit on Twitter because, you bash that game so much, now all of a sudden you love it, you're a hypocrite.
Yep.
Hey, but they can't say that Mooch didn't give it a shot, you know what I mean? They can't say, you never played it.
That's right.
And now he
right.
has.
That's right. I knew he'd love it. I heard him bash it over and over again, and some things I agree with him, some things I don't, and I knew that as soon as he tried it on Xbox, he was going to love it.
Yeah. Well, see, and that's a good thing about, having friends. Yeah. You don't have to agree. We're not sheep, you know what I mean? We don't have to agree on everything everybody says.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah, yeah.
Everybody has different opinions. Everybody's different, But that's the whole point of having a podcast where you can discuss it.
That's right. That's right, baby. And his analogies, man, oh my God. I could not believe, that time that I was on Crossfire Podcast, how quickly he just came up with that stuff, and I'm just like, Do you have these these written down, bro, in front of you? Jesus.
He could write a book.
Yeah,
the analogies,
He should be, a talk show host or something, man, on the radio, on TV.
Which is great.
Yeah.
He's a funny guy.
When I started listening to BGST, he's the one that really wrote me in, because he makes me laugh. Like I said, and I don't have to agree with everything he says, and
right.
I don't.
Right, right.
But he's entertaining as all hell, mm-hmm. and no matter what you think about him, you got to respect that.
Right. Absolutely. Absolutely. We had him on the show. He was great, man. He was great. We loved having him on.
Well, the thing about Mooch, if he likes you, he supports you 100%.
Yeah.
Yep. To know him is to love him.
Definitely. Yeah. Aside from this Mooch love fest that we just went on for the past 5 minutes.
I'm going to go write him a love letter right now. I'm going to send him a DM. I'm like, I love you, Mooch. I was talking about you for an hour.
I'm going to direct him to this podcast after the show and be like, dude, you got to watch this section of it. Watch it about 45 minutes on, 43 minutes on. You'll get a kick out of it.
Love fest. I love you, Mooch. Mwah. Kisses.
Too bad your cam wasn't working for that one.
Oh, I know. The camera would get all wet and sloppy.
Assassin, we want to get your thoughts on this. First of all, your thoughts on just the Xbox One version and then compared to the PS4?
I like the Xbox One version because there people on the PS4 have found, how they can play, and all these Xbox players are noobs and we can crush their dreams.
So you feel like you got a leg up.
Then why did we lose every game we played in the 7?
So speaking of which, when are we supposed to do this TXR / 4GwQPodcast?
Oh, hell yeah.
Showdown.
It's happening tomorrow at some point.
Did I read this correctly, or was there some kind of money wager?
There is some money. Yeah, there's some money on it.
Really?
Oh, yeah. Yep.
What exactly were the terms? Because I didn't see that.
Gonna have to go to Clowns on this one, Clowns. Go ahead, take it away.
$5 Xbox credit to each of the players. Yep. To each of you guys, if you guys beat us.
It's only a 5-minute game, South.
Come on. Up the stakes, baby. Make it worth my while. Now, honestly, it wouldn't be me playing. I'll tell you right now. Because you got 4 guys, we got 4 guys. 4 guys with losers. No.
Wow. On our show, even.
Hey, bro. We got to start the trash talking now.
Dude, it started the second the terms was set, dude. Twitter was blowing up.
Well, see, I didn't see exactly what I saw. So basically, it'll be Jeremy, Randall, Macca, and probably Tim.
Yep. I believe that's what it was. All right.
Who's going to be your four?
I don't know.
I don't know. It sounds like you're getting scared. I'm not intimidating, am I?
Dude, I didn't set the terms, bro. I don't know who the team is.
Who's taking up the tab is what I mean. Who's going to be paying it out?
This is all Clowns' thing, right? Assassin, you heard this.
Yeah, it's all Clowns. You're not getting a penny out of me.
Oh, it's going to be a tax write-off, huh?
Nope. No tax write-off.
Yeah, he's going to parlay. He's like, oh, yeah, it was a business.
No. We don't do tax write-offs. We don't make enough money to do a tax write-off. But Assassin promised he will do a rain dance before, so that's what convinced me.
Yeah, he can make it rain on us.
Yeah, that's what his plan is.
I want to see my account. You know, the money in my account go up. Boom, just go Microsoft points.
Right. Oh, geez. Yeah, so that's gonna go down tomorrow.
All right, so you guys will stream it, right?
Yeah, we'll have it streamed, for sure.
All right, nice.
Because
you know there's going to be a lot of shit talking, and it's going to be fun.
Oh, I'm sure there is.
Oh, I've seen Macca, man, he's pretty good. I've seen some of his
score. Real good, and Jeremy's fucking good, so you guys...
Cloud, you didn't tell me this. I thought they were scrubs.
No, not them.
Yeah, no, I'm pretty confident in my guys. I'll tell you that right now.
Those two are good. Yeah, I don't know about Rand. I haven't seen
him. Randall's good, too. That's what I'm saying. So.
Oh, wow.
But I will say this, though. Assassin has gotten 8 goals in one game, so we won 8-0 with Assassin.
Were you guys in the exhibition with no bots?
Yeah, bots, yeah.
No. We did this live last night.
Oh, really?
Yep.
Anyway, yeah, that's going to happen tomorrow. I don't know what the time is going to be on that, though. I guess that's how it's worked out.
We got to make sure Inferno is available.
Yeah, sometime like after 5, probably.
Midnight.
Inferno,
it has to be, you know, because I'm on the West Coast. Really, Jeremy's on the West Coast, so it's going to have to be later on.
Yeah.
What are your guys' like gaming times?
Midnight.
Bullshit, Assassin. No, anytime after 5 Eastern, I'd say we're all around.
Yeah, definitely. So, I mean, we'll be around. So, we'll get it set up.
Yeah, don't pussy out, guys. Come on.
No, I don't pussy out.
Pussy out. We're the ones who started it. Clowns is the one who started it.
I know, but you're getting nervous. Look at you. You're like shifty, looking left and right. Like, oh shit.
I'm looking at the chat, bro.
It's only me typing.
No way, J Street was just typing.
Just me, brother.
Wow,
I'm a shit talker.
We'll see how it is.
I think you guys are noticing this, but yeah, I'm gonna be the biggest cheerleader on Twitch.
Nice,
like TXR, rah rah rah, smash these fucking quarter guys.
You know what though? You guys gotta develop some or design some TXR flags. We should, design flags and put them on our cars when we play.
Yeah, I told Mooch that last night. I go, dude, you need to get your little, get Jay Williams to hook it up and get your little logo on a flag. How do you submit the designs to get them on there?
I'm not sure. That's a good question.
No idea. Yeah, Jay Williams is a good designer, man. He's got his shit down. That was Graphic God who was in the chat before. Yeah, he's really good.
Oh, was that Jay?
Yeah,
oh,
okay. Yeah, that was Jay.
Yeah, he's a good dude.
Yeah,
I've played with him and been on podcasts with him. He's a real good guy, you know. But our guy is Diego. That's our graphics man.
Yeah.
You seen what he's done.
Hey, what he did for you, bro? Wow, that was amazing.
Yeah, it's nice.
Put the city upside down and it just looks straight gangster. I really dug that one.
Yeah, it's really nice. Yeah, he's got a lot of talent too. I said to Clowns. What is that guy a designer by his day job? And Clown's like, no, he's like a stay-at-home dad or something. I'm like, no way. That guy's definitely got some design background.
Yeah, no, he definitely does that. I don't know if it's a full-time job or what.
Oh, okay.
He definitely makes money doing it.
Oh, okay.
You know, yeah, right? he's good, man. He's real good.
Yeah, and he's definitely blessed us, you know, with our first TXR logo. He's like, hey, listen, guys, you know, I've been listening to you. You know, here, boom, this is, you know, this is a present for you guys. Man, we're like, wow, that was touching, you know?
Yeah.
Because, listen, we got a few people that listen to us. I don't really like to say we got fans because I don't think that we're, fan, you know, we don't It's all family, you know what I mean?
Yeah, definitely.
I don't like to be like, oh, yeah, I have fans. Look, I'm Southbound. Kiss my ring. You know what I mean?
Right.
I've never been an Eagle guy, so to me, like, it's all fucking family.
Right.
And Diego's really blessed us, and he's been a big part of what we're doing and trying to accomplish. So anytime I get a chance, I'm like, Diego, shout right there, boom. He'll take care of you.
Yeah.
Because, like, the stuff he does for me, like, literally takes, like, 10 minutes. He'll be like, oh, I'm thinking of something, Sal. All right, cool. Let me know when you're done. And like 5 minutes later, he's like, "What do you think about this?" I'm like, "Fuck, that's amazing, bro! Holy shit!"
It's crazy, dude. These guys with like this background, all these backgrounds in design, like what they can produce in 10 minutes is just like mind-boggling to me. It would take me like 3 hours.
Yeah,
it's just ridiculous, man.
It was like that with De Niro, man. Like, I mean, like minutes later, it was like in my Twitter message, like, "Oh, here's what I come up with so far." I'm like, "Damn, dude, that was fast. That's like." 5 minutes in, you already got an idea what you're going to do.
Yeah.
And I will say, Inferno, you know what? What you're doing here on Twitch, it's quite impressive. I do have to give you your props. You know, I like your guys' setup and the layout and everything you got on the screen.
Thanks, so bro.
You guys are doing a good job, man.
I don't have any design background, so it takes me hours to do some of this stuff, man.
No, believe me, I know what it takes to put into a podcast. And, you know, it's definitely a job.
Like I said when we were on Crossfire together a few weeks ago, I said it's nice to be a guest on the show,
a guest, right?
And kick back and you know not click anything or whatever. But yeah, no, it's nice. Yeah, I like what we do here. And
no, you guys got a good format. You know what I mean? I'm a fan of you guys. Put it that way. You know,
Thanks, you guys
showing us love, and you know it's definitely reciprocated. And you know, anytime you need me to come on and babble and you know. Bug you guys, feel free to hit me up.
Oh yeah, baby. I know we can count on you.
And if you guys win that TXR soccer cars match, you can come on and gloat about it. You could be like, oh, we kicked your ass, dude. Oh,
shit, I'll be all over Twitter. You already know. I'm gonna have Diego make making a clown getting stomped by a big ass TXR.
Wow. Wow.
Hey, as long as you promise, if we win, can he do a soccer ball logo up Jeremy's ass though? Because Jeremy said that to me on Twitter. He's like, oh, I'm gonna show that soccer ball up your ass.
Wow.
I don't know if you want to see Jeremy's ass. I mean Hey, that's all you, bro. I ain't touching that one, but I'm sure he would. Hey, money talks. I'm sure right. He'll put Jeremy's balls on a soccer ball, you know what I mean? Hey.
Damn, dude.
You know, money talks.
All right, back to Xbox stuff, I think. So, I know, I don't really play Fallout 4, so, like, I have it, I don't really play it, so this isn't going to really apply to me. I know there are people on this panel, I don't know if you play it, South, really, but there are people on this panel that are pretty passionate about Fallout, so definitely going to have something to say about it. But
I've had, 7 days played on it.
Yeah, oh, really? Wow, okay. All right. So, the season pass is going up in price on March 1st. Going from $30 to $50. So if you want to get in on it now, buy it for $30 if you know you definitely want it, because it's going to go up by $20. Is this a big deal? Like, should people be pissed about this, or is it okay because they already said on Twitter that it's going to come with a ton of DLC?
The problem is, and I'm obviously cutting you guys off, so I apologize.
No, please, please.
It's we're talking about Bethesda here, and we're talking about Fallout. So a lot of things will be swept under the rug and forgiven.
Yeah.
As long as in the end that $50 price tag was really worth it. Because let's face it, people that were going to get the season pass already got it.
You think? You think everybody's...
I think a lot of people, you know, and the people that are on the fence, this is kind of like, hurry up and buy it now before it goes up. So, you know, it was kind of like a marketing ploy, like, listen, you're going to save $20 right now, so you might as well jump on it and get it now before the price goes up, you know?
Yeah,
it was like,
yeah.
It's like an old, you know, used car salesman that comes on TV. We got this one for $200, and you're like, holy shit, and you go there and it's gone, you know what I mean? So it's just to get you in the door.
Right. Interesting. So that's an interesting take on it, because what I've seen on Twitter and Reddit, people are like, they're increasing the price, how dare they? And it's like only a couple of weeks from now they're going to increase the price. It's bullshit. It's going up by whatever, 66%.
Well, buy it now then. Buy it tomorrow. You got 2 weeks to get it at the price that they originally set. So it's not like they're saying, you know what? We changed the price last night. So surprise.
Last night, nice.
You know?
Yeah. No, I agree. I mean, especially since they've said they're coming out with more, that it's going to include more than just the three that they announced already. And the fact that, you know, they're still giving you the head start. It's not like,
right.
I mean, it's 2 weeks. Yeah, it's only 2 weeks. But like, if you're going to buy, if you were thinking about buying it anyway, you've got that $30. Yeah, you know exactly. What I mean? It's not like you're picking the frigging couch for pennies and shit. Like, you've got that $30.
Here's my take on it, man. Like, I feel like it's Bethesda, and they are going to be forgiven, and I forgive them. It's perfectly fine with me, and I say that because, one, Bethesda gave us advance notice. I mean, they really kind of, like, gave us almost a month on it, I want to say. Like, at least a good 2.5 weeks. Second is that Bethesda, when they make their stuff, I mean, they do, like, large things, and they said they plan on doing more than what they had originally expected to do. So yeah, they deserve that price increase for it.
Cody, thoughts? I know you're a huge Fallout guy.
Oh, what, we're talking again now? Okay, sorry, I thought the Love Fest was still going on.
Oh Jesus, alright.
No, I mean, they gave you advance notice. What's to be mad about? They said, oh crap, we decided to do more than what we thought we would, so 2 weeks we'll give it to you for the original price. Other than that, we're going to charge you more, so
I don't think there's a big deal at all. Bro, you want to be hugged or what? You could be part of the Love Fest. It's okay.
He doesn't know those people. That's the problem.
I don't know any of these people.
Yeah, that's the problem.
Well, you know, I don't know you, buddy, but you know what? I love you. We're all God's children. They're like, holy shit, we're never bringing this Southbound guy on again.
No, they're like, they're bringing him back on, not me anymore.
No, Cody, stop.
Don't disappear in that darkness behind you, bro. That's kind of scary.
Yeah, it is.
Like, you got, like, the fucking abyss behind
you.
Dude,
literally, he can sit back in the chair and, like, half of him disappears.
Imagine the ratings of, like, something creepy just happened while he's on the podcast. Like, something popped out from behind him, like a werewolf or something, just grabbed him.
You did see our pre-podcast show and tell, right? I'm pretty sure I'm okay.
I think he's prepared. I mean, I don't know if we can show it live, but let's just say he's prepared for anything that may come his way.
I'm waiting for that zombie apocalypse to crack off.
That's right. That's right. So, yeah, Assassin, what do you think? Is it a big deal they're going up in price?
No, they promised a bunch of content. They gave us a few weeks to buy it. Yeah. Whatever.
You know what I'm really...
Yeah, I love that. He's just like, fuck, whatever. I'm buying it. I don't give a shit.
Here's what I'm amazed about, though, about Assassin here, and I'm going to just shout this on the air, and I want to thank him, is that he said, I'd rather buy the Fallout DLC over Quantum Break. I'm like, good job, Assassin. Good job.
What?
Really? No. You're going to get the Fallout DLC over Quantum Break?
No, because I get 4 free games compared to just the upgrade.
Wow. I don't know. I see where people are coming from. They're pissed about it. I mean, it's going up. It's going up by a lot of money. $50.
Yeah, but we're talking about Fallout. People are gonna forget about it. It's not even gonna be an issue.
I mean, the content will last you weeks. You know, like if you only game like 3 hours a day, could be months. You know,
how much time have you put into it, Cody?
2 or 3 days.
Wow. See, that's the thing. I'm like intimidated by this game almost because it like requires so much time. But
I haven't beat it yet, and I'm put in 2 or 3 days.
I think he's scared.
He is scared, dude. Yep. He is scared.
The Deathclaws. Pretty scary. Yeah.
I do have it though. I should get into it a little bit. I definitely should. I'm not gonna buy the DLC, but I should get into it.
I'm just disappointed in you. I mean, if they made a Fallout 5 South Carolina, I'd be all over that. I mean, shit.
Right, exactly. The game is like my hometown, so.
Yeah, you can probably find your house. Be like,
it makes Boston look rubble. Makes it look like a shithole.
Well, it kind of is. They didn't change anything. They just took pictures.
Right.
You know
right.
what? A lot of people say that they really locked down, or they really did well with the Boston accents.
See, I haven't heard any of, like, the voice acting or anything like that.
Yeah, I got a few friends that, you know, grew up in the, you know, the Northwest or whatever. Northwest. Yeah,
no, it's okay.
And they say, wow, they really did a good job with the voice acting. They really not locked it down perfect, the Boston accent. Because anybody could try to, you know, fake it and pretend to be. But I guess they really did a good job and locked out the part.
Yeah. I know it's a great game. I don't know why I can't get into it.
Something all those like settlements that you have to rescue.
I think you're scared about the honesty. You don't want to, like, look at the game and then be like, oh, shit, I live here?
Dude, I see these ugly streets and buildings and people every day. I don't know how it could be even uglier in the game. It is, though. It really is.
It is.
I like how, like, all the landmarks have the same names, though, too. You know what I mean? Like, they didn't I hate when games, like, change the names of stuff. Like, even, like, sports games where it's, like, the arena here in Boston is the TD Bank North Garden or whatever, the TD Bank Garden, and they can't call it that. They're just, like, Celtics Arena or some shit. Like, I hate when they do stuff like that. I know it's rights and everything, but, like, I hate it. Anyway, rant over. So far.
Well, you know, and on the other, you know, side of that, I like how GTA does it. They make their own funny name to certain landmarks and businesses and stuff. I think that it's quite cheeky.
Yeah. Yeah, I can get into GTA over something like this. I don't know why, but I can. It's crazy. I don't know. It's just
You know what? Fallout is kind of a niche title, and it's not for everybody, but it still is huge, and it has a huge following.
Oh, we lost Klaus somehow. We'll get him back. We're getting him back.
He'll jump back in.
So, yeah, I guess this is officially not a big deal, and we can go on to a different topic, I guess. J Street in the chat says, can't get into Fallout either, but I'm going to play it eventually. That's how it's going to be for me, too. But there's no way I'm going to complete it like these guys are. There's no way. In other news, Street Fighter V came out and sucks. Who saw this coming? You know what's interesting, though, and I know this is, like, really a topic for Mooch, but South, you and Mooch are, like, such good friends and everything. I know you know his stance on it for sure, and you probably have your own stance on it, too. But the meta score is in the 80s, but the user score is in the, like, the 3s out of 10 on Metacritic. How is that
possible? Dare I say media bias? I'm not one of them big, oh, it's a media bias, and, you know, everything, PlayStation's the best, and I'm not one of those type of guys. You know, obviously there's a discrepancy. You know, anybody that I talk to, you know, that has the game, they're pretty much huge Street Fighter fans, and everybody knows that the servers and the PSN is crap when it comes to Street Fighter. So it's really a bad, you know, press thing to have a stripped down game that you can only play certain parts of. And my whole point is, why they had how many betas and for how long?
Right, dude.
The betas, it was like 3 months of betas, right?
Yeah, off and on server adjustments, this, that, and the other thing. Like only certain play times, then they would take it down, fix stuff, bring it back up, and yet it comes out and people can't get into matches and.
Right. Well, what I mean, obviously, I'm not some network engineer and I don't know what all entails. But if you got a huge game coming out and it's not ready, don't release the fucking game.
That's right.
Take the hit on, say, you know what? The game is not ready. Give us another month. Give us another 2 months. We want to make sure that it's ready for our fans when the game comes out.
And not only is it, like you alluded to it a little bit, like there's no arcade mode, single player. Like there's a lot going on with this game that's not ready. And I thought we were away from this. I thought like stuff like The Witcher and The Division, like they delayed it, make it better, make it perfect. I thought we were like kind of getting over the hump here with releasing unfinished games like they did in 2014. I feel like I thought we were moving on from this trend, and then then this happens. Like, come on. Oh my god.
Yeah, it's not happening.
Sasson, I know you had some thoughts about this when we talked about it in chat.
I don't understand how you could release a game And, well, first of all, be broken. Shame on you. But then put DLC for your story mode. Like, come on. Seriously? Who puts a story in DLC?
Right.
Like, your game's broken.
Destiny! Oh, sorry.
Yes! 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 Destiny!
Sorry.
No, it's...
I had a little lump in my throat.
It's true. Yeah. Yep, definitely true. Good point.
But doesn't Street Fighter have more of a story than Destiny, though?
Probably.
My toe probably has more story.
Well, I don't want to hear about that, dude.
I don't know. It's very exciting.
Dude, Street Fighter's story modes or whatever for the characters is like 3 minutes right now. Like, they're like 3 minute introductions or something. It's oh man.
This whole Street Fighter fiasco is ridiculous. I mean, Capcom is a few generations behind, right? As it is. They go exclusive with PS4, which I don't know why they trusted PSN with this game and all their server issues they're having. And look at the reviews there. Yeah, I mean, what's going on? Something serious is going on.
Man, I don't know how this game's in the 80s on Metascore, man. I really don't.
I wonder if
money. Yep, just like Cody just didn't even say it, but he showed it on the screen. Money talks.
It could also be like some people that are just fans of Street Fighter. Some of these critics didn't even play this new one, and it's just like, oh man, this game's great.
Yeah, I don't get it. I did play the beta. I thought it was terrible. Like, I got to be honest with you. I didn't think it was that good at all. Did not get the same feeling I got when I played Street Fighter 4. I thought Street Fighter 4 was the tits. Like, I thought it was so good. And then they released this, and it's just like, seriously?
What was that quote from the fake Yoshida account? Is like, what was it? Everybody wanted a Street Fighter Alpha sequel, and now they got Street Fighter in Alpha or something.
Yeah.
What was that quote?
Yeah. Something like that. Yeah, it was like everyone wanted a sequel to Street Fighter Alpha, and instead Capcom released a Street Fighter game in Alpha. Yeah, exactly. Oh, my God. Anyway.
Now, all right, so let me ask you guys a question. Do you think that there's going to be a version of Street Fighter coming out on Xbox? I know they say, oh, it's not coming out. No. But you know, they always do the super hyper fucking definite
edition. That's right. Super.
Do you think that eventually some type of version of the game will come out for Xbox?
Super Street Fighter 5.
And going to this, having all the problems it's having, does it even matter now?
Street Fighter 5 beta on Xbox.
There you go. The alpha's out on PlayStation. They'll release the beta on Xbox.
Because that's a lot of people say, well, they're beta testing it for the Xbox community now.
It wouldn't surprise me at all. It would not surprise me at all.
I don't play fighting games, so I have no...
Right, neither do I. I completely suck at them, so it really doesn't matter to me one way or another. But it's just kind of interesting that if it eventually does come out on Xbox...
Yeah, is it going to be better?
Right.
Yeah, somebody... Was it last... I can't remember who said... it might have been last week in the show. No, because we didn't talk about this last week in the show. But somebody said... Maybe it was on Twitter or something. Somebody said, oh, wouldn't it be interesting? Oh, that's what it was. Yeah, somebody on Twitter said, wouldn't it be interesting if they released this on Xbox like in 5 or 6 months and it was completely perfect? Like, no problems with it whatsoever. And like the kind of trash that the PlayStation would get on
well,
that.
Well, and that's my next question is, okay, being that the mess that it is right now, in order for it to even come out on Xbox, would you think the guys are like, whoa, hold on. We don't want it until it's ready. Until it's, you know, tip-top shape and ready for Xbox Live.
Right. Yeah, would Microsoft even accept it? Yeah, that's a good
right,
point.
Right, no, exactly. Because right now, I mean, would you guys want a Street Fighter in its current situation?
I have a PlayStation. I love fighting games, and there's no chance I'm buying this. Not a chance.
Here's what I wonder. Here's the real question. How the hell can Capcom afford to pay that lupus fiasco to be playing this game when it sucks
lupus,
so bad?
Lupus fiasco. Yeah, that's good.
I mean, you know what I'm talking about, South, right?
Yeah.
You know?
Lupe beat, like, Dago, whatever his name is.
Yeah, it's supposed to be like some Street Fighter champ.
Yeah, I got beat by a freaking rapper.
And yeah, you see even his face, his reaction, like, holy fuck, this guy's beating me.
it was kind of staged.
What'd you say, Cody?
So there's like tons of links out there how it was staged.
Oh, you think it was staged? Ooh. That's it. That's interesting. That's an interesting take.
Cue the X Files music. The truth is out there.
Yep. I mean, maybe Capcom knew it was going to be such crap when it came out. They had to pay some rapper to help promote it. You know what I mean? Go to GameStops around Texas and promote it and whatnot.
Jay Street in the chat says, as long as people buy it, companies will do crap like this. Speak with your wallet. I agree with you, but on the same. In the same token, like, we saw the trend changing here, like, with The Witcher. Like, how good was The Witcher when it came out? Because they delayed it. And, like, Division has gotten delayed a couple times, and how good is that looking in beta right now? You know?
Like, Let me ask, here's the real question, though. When did Capcom put something out that was good that wasn't a remaster or a remake? When was the last time you can remember them making a good IP? Like, the next sequel IP?
Dead Rising 3 was pretty good.
But it had some flaws.
No, it was buggy as hell. Like, I was falling through the floor every 2 seconds, Assassin.
Yeah, I remember that. You couldn't
but it
that.
Was a good game, though.
Yeah, it was. Yeah. Yeah, I mean.
Well, I mean, besides from the bugginess and, you know, all that, it was a pretty damn fun game.
Yeah, yeah, for sure.
And I hopefully they announced the next one at E3. Yeah. Because it seemed like that studio's hiring right now. So hopefully they're working on it. Because we haven't heard nothing, you know, from it. So hopefully my buddy Phil went back to the drawing board and said, hey, listen, we need the next iteration ASAP. Well,
here's what I hope. I hope your buddy Phil went there and said, oh, shit, your last games suck. We're going to buy you out and make you guys good. That's what I hope.
Dude, first you got Microsoft buying Steam. Then you got Microsoft buying Capcom.
And no, I'm not dreaming. I want to see it happen. Let's make it happen.
Hey, guys, will this be on YouTube at some point?
Yes, it will.
Okay. If you can, our buddy Jamie Moran, he wanted to know if it's going to be on YouTube. So
it should have been broadcasted on YouTube right now. I tested it earlier, and for some reason it didn't work. I don't know what the deal is with that.
I think the category, maybe the gaming category you picked or something was on YouTube.
Oh, maybe not. We'll have to test it a little bit more. So sorry.
Yeah,
so
you're fucking fired, bro.
Oh, man, dude. This restream.
You know what?
Shit.
I'm just a guest here, but you know what? I'm fucking firing you.
Taking my spot, South?
Yeah, hell yeah. It's going to be one guy with three guys with quarters.
Oh, wow. Oh, my God. The cheeky chip wants to know if I have a Blue Yeti. Yes, that is a Blue Yeti. Sorry, I can't type in chat with this program. So, yeah, I mean, is there really anything else to say about the Street Fighter? It sucks. It's bare bones. They don't even have an arcade mode. Like, you can't even fight solo against the computer, for Christ's sake. Are you serious?
Oh, wait, but it's a PS4 exclusive that's going to be on the PC.
Crossfight, dude. You can fight against your PC people.
Yep.
Jesus, man. All right. Enough of that Street Fighter shit show.
Yeah, don't buy Street Fighter. Buy Plants vs. Zombies, Garden Warfare 2.
Yes, buy Plants vs. Zombies, Garden Warfare 2. Cody, did you play PvZ yet?
Did I play the beta or did I buy it?
He doesn't like it.
You don't like Garden Warfare? No way.
Get out of here.
No way.
On the darkness.
Just fall back, bro. Just fall back.
South, do you not like Garden Warfare either?
Yeah, no, it's good.
Okay, did you play Garden Warfare 2 yet?
Yeah, I played a little bit last night. I think they improved upon the first one pretty good.
Oh, yeah, dude.
I haven't really got too much into it, you know, but I'm definitely going to buy it now.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Yeah, South, on that game, you want to roll with guys like us. We usually win.
We're dominating earlier. Oh, my God. It's just so good. Like, when you think they can't, like, make new characters or, like, make new variants for the old characters and they just do it and... They throw, like, it feels fresh, even though it's a lot of the same stuff. It's just, like, done so well. Gotta check it out, people. You gotta check it out. Oh, this is an interesting question in the chat.
Yeah, EA Access. You can get on EA Access.
Exactly, right. That's exactly how we're playing it right now. It's not even out yet. Pay the EA Access is good. Like, if you're not gonna pay the 30 for the year, pay $5, try it out, you'll love it. And then, I mean, it's like renting a game. You can... Pay $5, you get a month of rentals, essentially. Definitely worth it. J3 in the chat wants to know, have you ever seen Phil Spencer's gaming setup, South? No? Hello? Is he not here? Assassin, are you there?
Hola.
Is South not there? I can't hear him.
Nope, can't hear him either.
Clowns, are you there?
I'm still here.
Weird. Assassin, it's those Indian dream catchers you get behind you, bro.
They're here.
Anyway, PvZ Garden Warfare 2. Assassin, is it everything you expected and then more?
Sorry about that, guys. I got a phone call. I had to mute my mic. What was the question?
Phil Spencer, have you seen his gaming setup? J Street in my chat wants to know.
No, I've never seen that. No. I've in his office, yeah. I've seen, you know, how he set up in his office at work, but I've never been to his house, obviously.
Right. Well, we got a person in the chat. I know you're a fan of the show. I've seen you in the chat before. I will say your name. Surprise Load says might have to buy an Xbox to reunite with us for Garden Warfare 2. I'm pretty sure I know who that is.
Is that Mustard Tiger?
I think that's Mustard, yeah. I think that's Mustard.
Or could that be Chaos?
No, I'm pretty sure it's Mustard. That's Surprise Load. Yeah, dude, come back to the light, baby. Play some Garden Warfare 2. It's amazing.
Assassin misses you, Tiger.
Right. We all miss you. The good old days.
Assassin, that's funny.
Probably has an Xbox in every room in his house, including his bathroom. Do you think he does?
I doubt it. No, I doubt it.
Is he... Do you think he has more than one Xbox in his house?
Probably.
Yeah, he has to. I'd say he probably has two.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, you know, that's
probably
one thing.
His theater room and in his bedroom.
That's one thing about those guys, though, like, you know, at the top of Xbox. I was like, they're very, I want to say they're very humble. I mean, like, they don't gloat, at least publicly. They don't brag publicly. And, you know, they talk about, like, good stuff about every company. And they have more than one system that they play on. And so I wouldn't be surprised if he's got, you know, more than just Xbox One.
Oh, yeah, I know he has a PS4. And, you know, I mean, they have to keep up with the competition. They got to see what they're doing, you know?
Yeah.
But, like, when the whole thing came out and they're like, well, the Xbox One takes forever to install games. He's like, listen, we're doing tests side by side to make sure the engineers are, you know, trying to get it the closest to, you know, to be, so they'll both be the same. There's no discrepancy between the two.
Right.
You know?
Right.
But you're right, though. You know, they are, you know, humble guys and really they really care about their fans, you know. But at the end of the day, you know, it's a business and they got to make money. And then, you know, but on the other side of the token, what other company, what other big, huge company gives their fans the access that they do, talks to them, interacts with them, you know? You don't hear about that, you know. Obviously, nope. They say, "Oh, well, it's because 2013 was a clusterfuck, and they had to do something." But you know what? If you talk to an Aaron Greenberg or a Mikey Barra, like it doesn't feel like you're a job. You know what I mean?
Yep.
It feels genuine.
Yep, it does. I mean, and don't just forget about the other guys at Xbox too. I mean, like Steinkin. You know,
that's my buddy right there.
He talks to everybody, dude. He's awesome, dude.
Because you know what? Because he's a fanboy. That's why. His level of fan is just through the roof.
He supported Doc's shirt, right? The Xbox One shirt?
Yeah.
That's awesome. Now that is awesome.
Yeah, he's a good guy, you know. And meeting him, I've met him a few times now. He's, like I said, you know, that's one question I always have for everybody that I meet. I'm like, is there an asshole in the Xbox division? Because I haven't met him yet.
Really?
Yeah. Like, everybody is fucking cool as shit to me. I'm like, oh, all right, come on. Wait till the other shoe to drop. All right, who, you know, do you guys ever have bad days where you're just like, you know, fuck everything, fuck everybody, I hate you? You know?
Yes, yes.
Because me, I would get, quit fucking tweeting me. I don't care a fuck about you, you know?
Yep.
But, like, they don't. Like, I'm not saying, you know, they're all fucking gods and they're perfect, but they're all pretty damn cool guys.
Yeah.
That's really awesome, man.
That's awesome. Xboxception assassin? What are you talking about?
You read the chat? Yeah, probably has an Xbox snapped with an X. Never mind. I'm not gonna read that.
You're absurd.
Oh my god.
Stop listening.
Assassin's the type of fan though, South, you gotta understand. He's bleeding green. He would rip off a shirt and be like, "Sign my stomach, guys. Sign it."
Hell yeah. Sign my titties.
Yep, that's Assassin.
That is there. Assassin, yep. Yep.
Definitely. That's good. You know what? We're all fanboys, you know. and the funny thing is, because sometimes they're like, "Oh, well, Southbound, he's an Xbox super fan." And I'm like, I kind of step back and I'm like, "Damn, that sounds like I'm a Uber dork." You know what I mean? Like, I got a package from Redmond a few months ago, and that's what it said on it. Super fan, you know, package or whatever. I forget exactly. I'll have to send a picture. I'll take a picture of the box. And I'm like, geez, well, I'm just a fucking dork. You know what I mean? But, hey, it is what it is.
You know, our other guy in the show that is not here today, Turtle, he's actually, I mean, he likes Xbox, don't get me wrong. But he's always been like more on the PlayStation side. But nothing. But the ironic thing here, the ironic thing is that Turtle had a friend that worked for Microsoft, uh-huh. And they actually on launch sent him a free Xbox One because he couldn't make it to E3 with them.
Nice.
So he had.
You know what? There was quite a few people that got an Xbox One for free.
Yep.
You know, I was really surprised that our buddy Randall didn't get one. You know, being he's a gamer score whore and he was so high up
that
people around him got one and he didn't. Which me, if that was me, I'd have been pissed. Yeah. I'd have been tweeting Larry and Phil and Aaron like, "What the fuck? Where's mine at?" You know, because I mean, honestly, nobody wants to feel left out. You know, and all your peers and everybody around you are getting some. Hey, what about me? It's human nature. Yep. Nobody wants to be left out.
You know, I've been tweeting at Major Nelson, and I'm like, dude, my wife wants that Hello Kitty screensaver. And he tweeted back that one time, he's like, never happened.
Right.
I mean, but we got to get that, South. My wife really wants it.
Oh, okay. Well, next time I'm up in Washington, I'll snag it. I'll steal it from the campus.
Wow. All right. Thanks, man.
But if you don't hear from me for a few years, it's probably because I'm in jail.
Hey, Aaron said, "Hey, I tried to get it too, but I couldn't."
Wow. All right, I don't think we have anything more than that. I think that's officially the longest podcast we've ever had.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I like to ramble.
No, dude, it was awesome. We'd love to have you here.
We need more of that on this show. I thought that was awesome, South.
We need more rambling or more South?
Yeah.
Both. We need more rambling South.
Rambling up South or just
rambling? We need more Southbound and we need more Southbound rambling.
Nice. All right. Anytime you guys are low on people, don't be afraid to hit me up.
All right. We definitely will not. Thank you, people who joined in the Twitch chat. People who were looking to watch on YouTube Gaming, sorry. I don't know what happened with Restream.io. But we'll figure that out for next week for sure. The replay will be on YouTube for sure. So look out for that on our YouTube. Just do youtube.com/4guysofquarters and you'll get to our channel. This picture here is lie. We do not broadcast Thursdays at 8. We started at 7-ish tonight. And I think that's what it's going to be from now on. But we'll let you guys know on Twitter and Facebook. So follow us there. Twitter is 4GwQPodcast. Facebook is 4GwQPodcast. And also, you know, follow us on Twitch if you haven't already and you're watching. Just click the follow button. And if you're watching the replay, you can still go to our Twitch, twitch.tv/4GwQPodcast, and just hit follow. And you'll be notified when we go live for not only the podcast, but all the other broadcasts we do. Played a little bit of PvZ together today, so that was on our channel.
And look out for the TXR/4GwQPodcast. Fucking fight to the death, rocket cars, soccer cars, Rocket League, whatever you want to call it.
That's right.
A fucking bloodbath.
That's happening tomorrow, so get ready for that. We'll post the times on Twitter, I'm sure. So
yeah, definitely.
Cody, thanks for coming on. Sorry you couldn't talk about Street Fighter.
Sorry.
But yeah, dude, the Quantum Break stuff was awesome. Too bad we couldn't show the guns. I mean, the what?
they're toys.
The toys. Yeah, so also, I forgot to shout out the website, 4guysrecorders.com. We got reviews on there. We're getting a lot more reviews. Cody's been helping us out on PR, so thank you for that. We're getting a lot more review codes, and we're going to have a lot of reviews on the site for new games that are coming out. A lot of indie games coming out that I've never heard of, but since we've had Cody working PR, I've opened my eyes and seen the light. So we'll have a lot of indie games and some retail releases too, reviews on the site.
And here's a little secret about Cody. He has friends inside Bethesda.
Ooh. Nice. That's a good connection to have. Because you know what? When I went to the VGAs and I got to meet Todd Howard, I was like awestruck. And I normally don't get all like, you know, starstruck and, you know, falling over myself. But like, I was talking to the guy that made Fallout and, you know, Oblivion and everything. And I was like, man, you guys got shafted. You should have got Game of the Year. You know, he looked at me and goes, eh, we've won it before. No big deal. And I was like, dude, you're the fucking man.
That's cool, man.
And last year, right around E3 time, Cody sends me a message. He's like, oh, yeah. You know, I was talking to, like, my guys at CD Projekt Red, got him invited for a few beers, and I got invited to Gamescom, but I just couldn't make it to Europe. I was like, what?
Yeah.
I was like, damn, dude.
Yeah, so Cody will be doing good work for us in the future, so I'm sure you guys will see more of him on the show and more of him on the site as well, so definitely look out for that. Other gentlemen that are here usually, thank you. Assassin, Clowns, love you.
Yeah. And South... Go ahead and give yourself a shout-out, your boys a shout-out, your crews a shout-out, your TXR stuff a shout-out.
Well, first and foremost, tomorrow, Crossfire Podcast. That's Mooch's thing. I'm you know, regular on that show. But tomorrow, he's going to be streaming with Major Nelson on Soccer Cars.
No.
Yeah, they're gonna link up tomorrow. I don't know exactly what time. You're going to have to look for Mooch for that one. But that should be pretty damn epic. You
yeah,
know?
No kidding.
Going back to talking all this shit about how Mooch, you know, was talking bad about Rocket Cars. But now, look at, he's going to be playing with Major Nelson, you know. Because when we're interviewing Ryan McCaffrey, Major jumped in the chat and was interacting on the chat. And Mooch is like, we got to stream Rocket Cars. Boom. He's like, yeah, let's do it. Well, so I don't know how it hooked up, but they got each other's email and they figured it out, and they're gonna be doing it tomorrow. So I don't know if it's gonna be during the day or in the evening. Hopefully it doesn't, you know, kind of cock block our little matchup.
Right.
But ours is, you know, not even that big of a deal. I want to watch Larry and Mooch go at it, so that should be fun.
Yeah.
So that's Crossfire tomorrow, and then our matchup tomorrow night. And then Monday nights, we do TXR, which Rand, Tim Dog, Jeremy, Worry Wart, Macca, you know, all of us, we don't have anybody scheduled for any kind of interviews for the next few weeks. So it's just going to be us blabbing our mouths out. So
it's all good.
If you get
it's
a chance, good. You know, check us out. If you like us, cool. If you don't, hey, nobody's perfect. You know what I'm saying?
That's right. That's right, baby. All right. Well, thank you, guys. We'll see you guys next week. Viewers, thank you very much. Peace out.